Hello everyone, welcome back to my page. I hope you're all having a fantastic day. Today we're going to be making a delicious punch that your entire family will enjoy. I promise you that. Now we're going to go ahead and peel a pumpkin. I find pumpkin very hard to peel, so I normally go ahead and slice it up. Then I remove the core. After removing the core, we're going to go ahead and use our vegetable peeler to peel it. Because the pumpkin skin is so thick, you want to be careful not to use a knife, especially a large knife. If you have a small knife, that's fine, but this can slip at any time and cut you, so you want to use a vegetable peeler. Next, I cut it up in cubes just so that they can cook evenly. I try to cut them in the same size. Now moving on to the carrots, we're going to go ahead and do the same. We're going to peel them and then I'm going to slice them. I initially took out 3 carrots, but I ended up using 4 because after peeling and cutting up the carrots, I realized that the pumpkin outweighed the carrots, so I just went ahead and peeled one more carrot and added to the batch. I really want the pumpkin to overpower the carrot taste. I wanted to be able to taste both of them in my drink, so that's the reason. If you don't have a problem, you don't have to, just use any amount that you want to. Alright, so after peeling and cutting up, I give them a final rinse and then we're gonna add them to our boiling water. My water is already boiling, and as you can see, I don't add too much water in the pot. I just need enough liquid to cook the vegetables and to also blend them. Also add a pinch of salt to add some taste to the drink. You don't have to add it now, you can add it afterwards, but I add it while the vegetables were boiling. And as soon as they cook, we're gonna take it off the stove and put it aside just to cool down a little bit before blending. I also added a cinnamon stick in there while it was boiling to give it added flavor. So now it's time to blend, and I'm gonna make sure that I add all the liquid from the pot into the blender. We need all the nutrients in there as well. We're gonna just pour it in and we're gonna blend it until it is nicely pureed. And if you have young toddlers, young babies that are now eating soft food, this is perfect for them, trust me. Instead of buying the one in the supermarket in the pouch, you can just boil the vegetables, blend it like this, and feed it to your baby. Once you're using fresh vegetables or fruits, whatever it is, once you blend it out as smooth as this, it's much healthier than some of the stuff that you will get in the stores. Alright, so if you have a child, you can think about that. Now it's time to add the rest of our ingredients. You can go ahead and add whatever sweetener you like. I'm gonna be using condensed milk. I have here 1 jug and stout. I'm gonna add the entire bottle. Next, I'm gonna add 1 can of condensed milk. And as I said before, sweeten to your liking. If you don't like condensed milk, maybe you could use some Lasco or anything that you want to add to your drink. All right, so after mixing the condensed milk and the dragon, I'm gonna go ahead and gradually add my pumpkin puree. And I'm also going to add some nutmeg. You can use some grated nutmeg or the powdered one from the store, whichever one works fine. And then I will taste it and see how much more cinnamon I because need. I already boiled it with cinnamon, but I'm gonna taste it first before adding my cinnamon powder. And of course, for added flavor, you're gonna need some vanilla extract. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and add our pumpkin and carrot puree. And the only alcoholic beverages that's in there right now is the dragon stout. And if you want, you can pump it up a little by adding some white rum, some rum cream, or some Baileys, whichever one you want to add. You just have to know that if you're gonna give this to kids, you can't add any of those. All right, so I have some Baileys and I have some white rum. I'm gonna add just a little bit. I don't want to overpower the drink, so just a little bit. And remember, this is optional. As I said before, you don't have to add any of this. Your drink will taste fine just the same. However, I am making a punch and I need that alcohol in there just a little. All right, and then our drink is perfect. I'm gonna go ahead and taste it, and after tasting it, it didn't need anything. It was perfect. You can taste every component in this drink. I'm gonna go ahead and just take a picture, and then we're gonna add this to the fridge for Sunday. This was Saturday night and I put it up for Sunday to have Sunday evening, and it is all done. Believe me when I tell you, it's all done. It's finished. It's nice, rich, it's smooth, and everyone loved it. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you're having a fantastic week. Stay safe, show some love, and I'll catch you in my next video.